Dear Prime Minister, dear Anna, dear ministers, your excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, thank you. Thank you very much for this impressive and excellent Western Balkans Digital Summit in Belgrade. I would like to thank personally Prime Minister Ana Brnabić for hosting the summit, and I congratulate you, you and your team, for this excellent and timely organization. I'm particularly glad to be here with you today because, yes, much has been achieved since we last met in Skopje. And indeed, as last year, we gather here today with one idea in mind: to assess the implementation we launched in Sofia last year and to make the most out of the opportunities brought by the digital transformation of our economies and societies by securing direct benefits for our citizens. Remember, in Sofia, our leaders committed to the objectives of the digital agenda for Western Balkans, namely investing in broadband connectivity, increasing cybersecurity, trust, and digitization of industry, strengthening the digital economy and society, boosting research and innovation, and accelerating the adoption, implementation, and enforcement of the European acquis in the area of digital single market. Yes, this is not words, and we prove it. Since last year, a strong political will for change has been shown throughout the region. We have cooperated to ensure we progress together on the implementation of the digital agenda for Western Balkans. You know, I have traveled in the region to witness the firsthand the efforts. And throughout my visits, I noticed the strong commitment by all stakeholders to this agenda. We have gathered today to witness the signature of the new regional roaming agreement among the six partners of the region, which will bring significant benefits for citizens and to businesses in the region. Let me be clear. This is your agreement, not ours. We have fully supported this process, and I would like here to thank the Regional Cooperation Council. Thank you very much, my Linda, for your engagement, for the energy of RCC. This signature is a solid demonstration of strong political will towards achieving a robust digital regional integration. I'm grateful to all those who invested time, energy, political and economical capital for making possible today's signature of the new regional roaming agreement in the Western Balkans. Let me share my appreciation to the Republic of Serbia for your efforts, for the first draft of the regional roaming agreement, and for hosting the signature. It's a very clear signal for your role in this process. It's a very strong signal for regional cooperation, for European perspective. And let me also thank the whole region, the ministers responsible for digital, the regulators, as well as the telecom regulators. Again, let me thank the RCC for the central role as facilitator in this process. Dear Mylinda Brego, Secretary General of the RCC, I would like to personally thank you for your commitment always put to the service of enhancing dialogue and integration in the Western Balkans region. From our side, I'm glad that we, as European Commission, we were able to provide technical input based on our experience with regulating roaming services within the EU. You can count on our firm support. Your citizens and businesses will soon enjoy lower roaming prices when traveling in the region. The next step is reaching the same agreement but this time with the European Union. And yes, immediately after this great historical day, we'll start to work in this direction. Allow me to be clear. Today, we are not only making our partnership stronger. Today, you have added an important stone in the European path of our Western Balkans partners. This is something we can all really be proud of. Allow me in the next minutes now to outline some of the other significant accomplishments. Because yes, digital agenda for Western Balkans, it's not only a declaration. It's not only an intention of action plan. We have achievements. We delivered. And now it's time just to share some of those results. First, the region has realized important improvements on broadband in many ways. By doing broadband mapping, drafting broadband strategies, and by rolling out broadband. On this topic, you know, as a European Commission, we have made 30 million euros available for technical support as part of the Western Balkans investment framework. The existing projects, both planned and ongoing, will increase the rollout of broadband in the region, especially targeting less populated and remote areas. And we all know how important are those areas for our countries. Second, there were political engagements to prepare ICT strategies and to adopt laws on cybersecurity in line with our European Network and Information Security Directive. This will strengthen and make the economies safer. Third, on 5G, a memorandum of understanding on the creation of 5G corridor between Thessaloniki, Sofia, and Belgrade was signed in June 2018. This is an important step to link Western Balkans to the cutting-edge research of the European Union. Fourth, in support to the promotion of digital skills, you know how is close this topic to my heart. Over 1,000 events were held throughout the Western Balkans during the last year's edition of the European Code Week, 3 times the number of the year before. Digital skills are important, and making sure our children, our young people, our active people have the necessary foundation for a modern society is crucial. Fifth, in view of the region's European path, we have made common efforts to open the existing European networks to the Western Balkans partners. For example, the broadband competence offices, the cross-border traineeship initiative, digital opportunity traineeships, and ERGA, the European Regulators Group for Audiovisual Media Regulators. Sixth, another milestone was Montenegro becoming the first candidate country to join the European Program for Interoperability Solutions for Public Administrations, Businesses and Citizens, known as ISA Square. This will speed up the digital transformation of their public administration. And we welcome that besides Montenegro, other partners are considering to become part of ISA Square. Talking about public administration, yes, we have a clear reference in the European Union, that's the Declaration on e-Government signed in Tallinn in 2017. That reflects our political commitment towards the modernization of public services. And we therefore welcome that Western Balkan economies join our vision for public services by committing to the principles set out in the European e-Government Action Plan and by cooperating closely within the region to define common actions based on national and regional policy priorities. Further, a significant achievement is the inclusion and participation of Western Balkans national regulatory authorities in the body of European Regulators for Electronic Communications, BEREC, with the aim to bring regulatory practice in the region closer to the practice in the Union. Yes, as a Commission, we have adopted a decision establishing terms of reference for the participation of NRAs of the region in the Board of Regulators. In addition, and this is an important issue for me, I welcome that you have placed cybersecurity on top of the political agenda. You have expressed to me eagerness to cooperate with the European Union Agency for Cybersecurity, ENISA. And you know that we already have finalized the negotiations with the European Parliament and the Council. Stronger cybersecurity agency with human resources, with operational tasks. So I welcome your common efforts to enhance the region's cybersecurity and resilience. In this sense, I also welcome your efforts to embark upon the mutual recognition process for trusted services in full compliance with the electronic identification and trust services for electronic transactions in the internal market regulation, so-called EIDAS regulation. Now, what is important that our efforts in the digital agenda for the Western Balkans have also yielded results for our businesses and citizens. That's the most important. Indeed, startups are thriving everywhere nowadays, reminding us how important these companies are for the economic growth of our countries. I want to see more examples like Content Insights, Strawberry Energy, or Giraffa, startups coming from the region. This is why, remember, at the previous edition of the Startup Europe Summit in Sofia on 15th of November, we launched the Startup Europe Central and Eastern Europe Network and Western Balkans Network. They are focusing on existing barriers for growth in the region, and I'm very proud of their work. They will present today a set of concrete and actionable recommendations for leaders and policymakers of the Western Balkans. We just had another meeting in Cluj in Romania 2 weeks ago, and I encourage you, all of you, to meet them and contribute to the network with the aim of building a stronger startup ecosystems in the region. As regards other relevant networks, like the European Artificial Intelligence Alliance and the European Blockchain Observatory and Forum, I think more stakeholders from Western Balkans should join, because this would highly enrich the discussions on these key issues. We count on you. On this same note, as you know, we, as the European Commission, we have launched the Digitizing European Industry Strategy to reinforce competitiveness on digital technologies and to ensure that every business can fully benefit from digital revolution. An important part of this is the establishment of digital innovation hubs. These digital innovation hubs are one-stop shops that help companies to become more competitive with regard to their business production processes, products or services using digital technologies. Now, after 1 year in the Western Balkans, 6 digital innovation hubs are operational and 16 are in preparation. With your increased support, the number of stakeholders could increase. Ladies and gentlemen, I could continue to enumerate tangible deliverables achieved so far of the digital agenda for the Western Balkans. I have personally witnessed them when I visited the region, and I'm well aware of the process and efforts each administration, each government, each ministers, each prime minister has gone through this year to make possible all the accomplishments I mentioned. These efforts are the solid foundations for strong economies and interconnected region. And of course, in line with aspirations of the partners to maintain their steady European path. As already discussed with many of you, I also look forward to opening the first European Union Western Balkan ICT dialogue in Brussels. We propose to organize this at technical level on 9th of July, so we can take stock of progress, plan the next steps, and identify areas needing more efforts. And this digital summit in Belgrade is a milestone for this process. I'm convinced, you know me, that only by working together, hand in hand, in a true spirit of cooperation, we can achieve a truly connected, enhanced, dynamic and digital partnership between the European Union and the Western Balkans. I'm proud of all your efforts. I'm proud of all your achievements. This is a very strong signal for your young, talented people, for your startups, for us as Europe. It is in our hands now to continue to show example, to be leaders, and we can do it. Thank you very much for your attention.